Today I will be talking about the 2020 Marin Wildcat Trail 5. If you're new to this channel and you like riding bikes, gear reviews, and tutorials, then don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button down below. Without further ado, let's get started. So let me start off by talking about how I started mountain biking. As you know, many of my videos are primarily on the road bike, riding with my husband, going on these fun adventures with him. But lately I've been wanting to explore the trails and spend time in nature. That's when I decided that I would try mountain biking. The process I went through to decide on the Marin was fairly simple. There were three criteria: affordability, reliability, and the drivetrain. I wouldn't necessarily consider the Marin to be a bike for most beginners. I would say it's for those who understand how most bikes work, especially the gearing options. With that being said, I was looking for a bike that had optimal gear range for climbing and a 1x setup, a wide cassette, and an 11 speed. To bring the price down, I was particularly looking at hardtails as they are not as expensive as their full suspension counterparts, and they are also a lot lighter. So for climbing, I feel like I don't run out of gears to choose from. The 1146 cassette is spinny and a godsend in those steep, rocky climbs. Coming from a road bike with an 1132 cassette, it's a huge welcome and a gift to have. The 2¼ tires are wide enough to give you a plush ride on rocky sections and a nice grip over rocks, roots, and ruts. It has yet to fail me as I'm not running tubeless on this one. That was how I narrowed my choice down, as the big name brands like Trek and Canyon don't really offer hardtails and they go beyond my price point. I've also read and listened to other people's testimonials on how good these Marin bikes are and how they are also very well made. For me, as long as people are riding their bikes, then I assume it's fairly reliable. On my first ride, I felt very comfortable riding the Wildcat. I felt as though it was easy to get used to mountain biking. My body just knew what to do to handle the trails, especially on the fire roads and double tracks. The true testament, though, was on the single tracks. If you're a subscriber to a channel and you've been watching a lot of my videos, you've probably seen that I have crashed a couple of times on the mountain bike already, especially on the single tracks. I still have a lot of work to do with my skills there and have fears riding extremely technical sections with serious twists and turns. But I'm hoping once I hone in my skills and learn to manage my fears, I can be successful in it. So with the pros, there are also cons. The Wildcat is fairly heavy. I'm coming from riding a carbon fiber road bike that weighs 15 pounds to an aluminum that weighs almost close to 30 pounds in a size small. People have said, well, it's a Marin, what do you expect? The Shimano DR derailleur is in combination with the microshift shifters are not ideal for me. I've said in the past that I feel like I'm getting a real thumb workout. It's not as responsive as I'd like, and I'm one to shift up and down constantly, especially in the trails, depending on the changing terrain and conditions of the trail. So if you have a couple of $100 to even $1,000, I would suggest spend a little bit more on a better group set, better drivetrain. In conclusion, I learned that mountain biking has really worked to improve my skills on the bike itself, whether it's the road or the mountain bike. I feel more confident on the road bike when reacting to sudden changes like cars turning and crossing intersections, because on the trail you come across these varying degrees of changes in the terrain. I've also been enjoying exploring new trails nearby, which has opened a whole new world of riding for me. I set aside an hour on Saturdays each week just to ride the mountain bike and continue to practice my singles track skills. So that's it for my beginner's review of the Marin Wildcat Trail 5. I hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comments section down below. And until next time, don't forget to enjoy the ride. Bye-bye.